4 habits to increase your self-esteem. But first, like and subscribe to the channel and share this content. Hit the notification bell so that you're aware when I post a brand new video. 4 habits to increase your self-esteem. Number 1. Focus on your own self-development. Whether it be spiritually, mentally, physically, financially, or any other area of your life, as a woman, you should always be focusing on improving yourself in some way. Whether it be your intellect, you know, you want to learn something new, you want to go back to school, you want to take a course, earn a certificate, or just study on YouTube and learn a new skill. Doing those type of things will increase your confidence, which will overall increase your self-esteem. And then spiritually, spending time with God and being reassured of who you are, aside from who society says you are, definitely helps you. And then mentally, when you are able to tune out those things that distract you, tune out those things that are going to discourage you, you become more self-aware and you become more confident because now you're blocking out the other voices and you're leaving room to hear your own thoughts, your own opinions, your authenticity. You're able to actually hear that and be connected to that when you block out other things. And then financially, when you focus on leveling up financially, that boosts your self-esteem because you're no longer worried about how you're going to make it or how you're going to buy certain things because you're focusing on developing in that area. So the number one way to increase your self-esteem is focus on your own self-development. When you get laser focused on becoming a better woman, that's when you will see your confidence and self-esteem begin to increase. Number one. Number two. Stop comparing yourself to other people. When you constantly compare yourself to other people, you will never measure up as a woman. When you begin to realize that there's only one you and that nobody else can be like you or do what you do at the level that you do it, you become more self-confident and your self-esteem begins to increase. So when you begin to focus your attention on being like the next woman, or I wish I was like her, I wish I could speak like her, I wish I could look like her. There's nothing wrong with using women as inspiration. I've said that on previous videos, but you don't want to go all out and try to copy someone else because you can never be someone else. You can only be yourself. I used to struggle with that. Earlier on when I was just developing as a woman in my 20s, because as you might see by now, I am reserved, but I am a woman who was able to teach. And because of that, I have that more of a, you know, kind of go type of personality, not kind of mousy. I'm very confident and assured of what I'm saying. And to some people that can come off as cocky. So what I used to do is have to just shrink back. You know, I didn't really want to do too much or say too much, but as I grew in my self-esteem and my confidence and who God created me to be, I no longer felt the need to just shrink back in order to make other people feel comfortable. And then a sidebar, when you have been suppressed as a young lady when you're growing up, sometimes you grow up to be that shy kind of mousy type of woman who wants to just shrink back into the background. But when you stop comparing yourself and you get rid of those, those old sayings and self-talk that you grew up with that allowed you to suppress your emotions, and you just say, forget about that, I'm confident in who I am as a woman and I'm going to be myself. Then you will stop comparing yourself to other people and just be. You become more confident, you become more self-assured because you're no longer allowing what other people told you to stop you from being the confident woman that you know you are and want to be. And then when you stop comparing yourself to other people, you realize that there's something unique about you that no other woman has. So when you think that way, that will automatically boost your self-esteem as well. And then number three, no negative self-talk. You cannot have a healthy level of self-esteem if you are constantly highlighting your flaws. If you're constantly highlighting everything that's wrong with you, you will never be self-confident or display self-esteem. So as a woman, you undoubtedly have insecurities and you might have different things that you want to work on, but instead of constantly complaining and saying what it will never be, focus on what you want to change. And this kind of ties into number one with the self-development. When you see things about yourself that you don't like, now, if there's something about yourself you don't like, such as, you know, you think you've gained too much weight, or, you know, you think you eat too much, you know, those kind of things you can kind of control. But there are certain things about yourself that you're just going to have to accept. Let's say, for instance, and I'll be completely transparent with you. When I was coming up, I was very self-conscious about my nose. I always thought that my nose was too big. I always thought my forehead was too big. And because of that, I felt very self-conscious. And of course, you know, coming up as a young girl, I heard little jokes people would say about my forehead, these different things. And not so much about my nose. That was just kind of a me thing. But my forehead, oh my goodness, so many jokes. So of course, that kind of beat into my confidence, beat into my self-esteem as a woman. And I carried that over as I grew up. But as I began to mature and become more self-aware and become more confident, I started to embrace my features. Look, there's nothing I can do about my forehead. There's nothing I can do about my nose, and I don't care. I will never, ever get under anybody else's knife in order to change my facial features. I don't think that's God's will for me. So as a woman, you just have to accept what you have and work with it to the best of your ability. And that's what I began to do. And do you know, when I started accepting the fact that, okay, you know what? You got this big forehead. It's not going nowhere. You got this wide nose. It's not going anywhere. I began to get more compliments. And you know why? Because I started carrying myself in a more confident way. I didn't look at my nose and my forehead as if it was something to be, you know, ashamed of, as if I was like deformed or something. I actually embraced my uniqueness. And people ask me all the time, where are you from? You know, and I'm from the United States. I'm from Jersey, you know. So I'm not from anywhere exotic, and I'm not saying, because I can see this now, in order to be looked at as beautiful, you have to be from somewhere exotic. No, I'm just saying that this is what I've been told, what I've been asked. Where are you from? And it's not because of how I look, I believe. It's because of how I'm carrying myself as a woman. I'm no longer, you know, being, you know, very mousy and being very shy and timid. I'm now more confident, humble, but confident. Okay. So stop highlighting your flaws and embrace what you have as a woman and work with that. If you have features that you don't necessarily, you know, nothing you could do about it, but if you could change it, you would. Do things to make it look better. You know, for the longest time, I used to wear bangs. When I was in high school, I would wear bangs until I realized it was breaking out my forehead. And I said, you know what? I'm flipping this hair back and it's going to be what it's going to be. And I focused on my skincare. So because I have a big forehead, going back to that, I knew for me it was important to focus on making sure my face card look as best as I can make it look. So I would do facial mask, face mask, not put too many products on my face, not scrub my face so hard, you know, just doing things to make me look and feel better. And that made me feel more confident about my facial features. Okay, so number three. Do not constantly talk about and highlight your flaws. If anything, do your best to fix them. And most importantly, accept them, because you're going to live with you for the rest of your life. You have to accept that. Okay. And then lastly, number four, surround yourself with people who will encourage you and inspire you to be better. So as women, your self-confidence no doubt starts with you. But you do not want to surround yourself with people that are going to place doubt in you, or people that are going to affirm your doubts. You want to be around people who are going to get you to understand how beautiful you are, or the reason why you shouldn't really feel so bad. You don't want to be around people who are going to tell you, well, yeah, girl, your forehead is a little big, but whatever. And there's nothing wrong with somebody being honest, but you understand as a woman, and I will always go back to this in certain videos because I'm black, especially as black women, some of us can be very rough and we can make people feel very unassured of themselves and our approach to how we call ourselves encouraging other people. Have you ever been to a function where you've lost a lot of weight the last time they saw you? And instead of saying, girl, you look good. Oh, what you been doing? They'll say, oh, you lost a lot of weight. What, you sick? What's going on? What's wrong? because in our community, being overweight is glorified. So when they see you looking fit and trim, for the most part, they're going to try to say something to try to make you feel like there's something wrong with the fact that you lost weight. Of course, this doesn't go for all households or all black women, but for the most part, from my experience, when you lose weight and the butt is not as big as it used to be, they're looking at you like there's something wrong with you. We have to normalize having normal BMIs, body mass index. We have to normalize being healthy and looking healthy. That's just a little sidebar. But surround yourself with people that are going to encourage you, not discourage you. And then also go into environments where people are doing what you want to do and being how you want to be. So if you are a woman that's suffering with low self-esteem, you don't want to be around other people who are also suffering with low self-esteem and constantly talking negative about themselves. You all should be able to encourage one another, but for a season, you might have to get around some people that you might feel intimidated by. Some people that you deem is looking better than you, having more than you, doing more than you, because you know what that's going to do. It's going to motivate you to do better. So as a woman, if you want to increase your self-esteem, start looking at the women that you aspire to not be like, because I said you don't want to compare and just try to be someone, but there's nothing wrong with getting inspiration from other people. And getting inspiration and trying to just be somebody all on out is completely different. And I hope you understand that. So surround yourself with people who are doing and being and moving the way you would like to move, and get inspiration on that, and then make it your own. If you see a woman that walks graciously and she's confident and she has her neck up and she's just, you know, confident in her approach, you try to be that way. So when I say be like other women or inspire, you know, use inspiration from other women, don't copy their lives, but maybe their mannerisms and the way they talk and the way they move. But then put your own personality, your own spin, your own way on it. There's nothing wrong with that. And that will absolutely help you to build your self-esteem. So to reiterate, 1, focus on your self-development. 2, stop comparing yourself to other women. There is only one you. 3, stop highlighting your flaws. If you see something about yourself you want to fix, work on that. If it's something you can't change, accept it. And then 4, surround yourself with people who will encourage you and inspire you to be better, be more confident, and don't mimic their life, but look at their mannerisms. If you have a woman that is more gracious and kind and gentle, you can try to mimic that and make it your own. 4 habits to increase your self-esteem. Like and subscribe to the channel and share this content. Hit the notification bell so that you're aware when I post a brand new video. If you watch this video until the very end, hit that high heel emoji and put it in the comment section. And most importantly, hit the like button so that YouTube will send this video out to more women and we'll grow our community. All right, take care.